once upon a time, in a wild, wild world.
All right, here we go.
There
synopsis
were two
time.
Wolf brothers living in their home lair with their Papa Wolf. They lived in peace until hunters took their dad away. And they had to go on the run. That's when the big brother discovered.
The little brother was a freak! No,
he's not an ordinary wolf.
I've been doing GTA
but a
shit.
Super
Wolf.
What'd
you do?
They discovered a secret hideout where they could train day and night. They were happy. But the little wolf got very sick, and they had to move on. The brothers made it to the home of their ancestors. And
well,
the old
maybe you should stop trying to break stuff, Teddy.
Unfortunately, the hunters were hot on their trail and found them. The brothers had nowhere to stay again, so they decided to keep going south.
And now we're getting into what
they
we were
soon
in
entered
last
the
time.
Old forest of the giants.
The last episode.
Where they met a pack of stray dogs who worked in a secret farm.
The pot farm.
The brothers joined them and worked hard to stock up on gold for the future. They were happy to find others like them.
Oh, that sucks, dude.
And everybody loved the little wolf,
yes,
who was growing up fast.
Wait, there's an otter.
His power
wait, so Elsie the otter?
The little wolf was more and more confident and independent. The big brother hooked up with a cool she-dog.
She-dog?
They had their own adventures.
Oh, I don't know. I had to go
suddenly,
live at that point. I didn't watch that far into
the main
it.
The farmers who owned the land tried to hurt the brothers. The little cub was injured.
No.
He transformed into a super wolf.
Little wolf and...
And destroyed everything.
Dumbass high guy decided to fucking rob
the brother
farmers.
Was badly wounded. And worse, he didn't know where the little cub was.
We lost our little bro. Alright, so I'm assuming we're picking it right back up where we were in the last episode. Or maybe a couple of days later. Hey, what's up, Rogue? How are you doing tonight? I can't wait for the remake, Resident Evil 3, next week. Kind of pissed that the beta's all screwed up, though. Alright, Teddy. Wait, that's not the haircut we got. Or are we going back before? Uh-huh. Just tired,
hey,
gotcha.
Sean. I'm sorry.
I was gonna say, didn't we get like a cool mohawk going?
I didn't mean to. It was a bad idea.
Daniel. No way.
It was just some time later.
It's all good.
It's all good in the hood. No, because he's still
wish
in his
I
zombie clothes for Halloween.
When you tried to stop me from going with Finn.
Or no,
I
you're
was
not.
Too pissed.
It's okay, dude. You're my brother. And that's all that counts.
So, why don't you come and get me? I'm alone, Sean. I don't know what to do.
Or is he having a dream? Oh, he must be having a dream.
I'm scared.
Little dude gonna jump.
Don't get so close to that edge.
Please, come and get me.
Yeah, I don't know what that means, Rogue.
I swear.
I know what COD it is, but I don't know what the rest of it is. Ah!
Stop!
That's not the haircut we got either. Where's my fucking mohawk at? Hospital in North California. 2 months after the blast at Marl's. Holy shit. How are we not in prison right now?
Fuck. Daniel.
bouncing ball.
Can't catch shit.
Hand-eye coordination.
Zero depth perception.
Mm-hmm. That's why you
need two
eyes.
Goodbye, sports. Yeah. Thanks for the card, Agent. Can't wait to text you. Glad Steven's leg is better. Must be tough on Claire.
We are grateful to find out that you are safe and awake. The police contacted us when you were found unconscious in Humboldt County. We weren't allowed to visit you in the hospital, but we want you to recover ASAP. The doctors say that you woke up from that coma stronger than before. Well, that's good. Sucks he was in a coma, though. The most important thing now is to find Daniel. We are helping the police any way we can. They really want to help find him, too. Sean, hopefully this reflects well during your trial. We know this must be hard for you after everything you and your brother have been through. You're both in our thoughts and prayers every day and night. Remember, you are family and we love you. We hope to visit you in, what is that, Jolina Shore as soon as we can. Take care, Claire and Stefan. P.S. Chris insisted we write a little note. It's attached to this letter. P.P.S. He doesn't know Daniel is missing.
Don't know if we'll ever come back, Chris. Miss that little superhero.
Aww. Hi, Sean and Daniel. I hope you're okay. I'm fine, but I miss you. I miss both of you a lot. When are you coming back? Dad has been better lately. He says hello, and we are fishing now. That summer is here. Yay, that's cool. We do a lot of stuff outside now. All the snow is gone. You should come back to see Beaver Creek without the snow. I'll be waiting for you. Chris and Captain Spirit, P.S. We need to save Beaver Creek from the swamp bugs. That's awesome. I like the little cartoon down at the bottom, too. And there's Cassidy's letter. Hey, hey, what's up, girl?
I miss Cass so much.
Oh, she couldn't even
hear it. Wish I could hold her.
Howdy, city boy. Bet you're surprised to hear from me. I found out you were in the same hospital from the police after we were questioned when I was checked out a month ago, so I took the chance to write and hope you get this. Wish I could say everything I want, but you never know who's reading, right? If anybody else read this. Fuck you! I truly hope you were okay after what happened. As for me, I don't remember much except the explosion at Merle's office, and then I woke up in the hospital with blunt trauma healing and what the doctors called blast lung injury hurting. It's like from the shockwave damaged her lungs and shit, the insides. It takes like a shockwave blasting. I've heard that shit sucks. Hurts every time you breathe and shit. It's like having broken ribs all the fucking time, but they're not broken. Just glad that I can still play the guitar and sing now that I feel like it. You learned a shitload about medicine stuck in a hospital bed. As I'm sure you know, my sweet compadre, still working on my Espanol. Miss my lessons and my teacher. You probably know more about what's going on than me, but Hannah, Penny, and I were released without charges. The police were stoked to bust a farm of drug traffickers rather than us gutter punks trolling in a field. We asked about you and Daniel and got no answers. Surprise. So with Finn and you gone, our round family is kind of broken up now. We're just a lonely trio, train hopping up and down the state, but it feels like we're going in a loop to nowhere. Hannah and Penny aren't the same, and we fight too much. I'm not even sure we'll be together for much longer. Shit chances, right? Maybe I'll have a whole new set of blues songs for the road. I know you're going to trial soon over the Seattle situation, and you will get justice and freedom you deserve. Oh shit, Teddy, thank you for the sub, man. God, I can't watch him, he's too like, uh-oh. Hey, Gwen, how are you? I read, I saw what you put on Discord. I hope you know I sent you a DM. So, I don't know if you read it yet or not, but... where was I? You and Daniel are amazing brothers, and I hope you find your way home soon. I hope we can swim naked again under the new moonlight. It's a big world, and maybe we'll meet again someday. I'll always be singing your song. Love and peace, Cassidy. Aww.
Aww. Cassidy misses him. He's dead too.
Teddy, again, thank you, man, for the resub. 8 months.
Yeah, man. Fucking getting there.
You'll have your ear badge soon.
Ugh, can't even focus on the page. This sucks ass, man.
March 26 was in a coma for weeks, blind and fucked. Plus, in police custody. In police custody, going to jail. Hospital freaks me out. Hate this. Where's Daniel? I'm scared. Of course, Gwen. No problem. Tried to draw to kill time. This room is like a cage, but I suck now. No death perception, no art, no shit. Focusing, immediate migraine. Going crazy in here. Woke up crying. Ow. Yeah, I had similar issues after a car accident I was in. I couldn't draw anymore. My left hand was destroyed. April 3rd, 2017. Secret, or Special Agent Flores. She's trying to bond with me, trap me, or trust me. So fucked. Cops still can't find Daniel after the explosion, so he's out there alone. Happy birthday, Daniel. Wherever you are, Nano. April 15th, 2017. Claire and Steven sent me a nice letter. So lonely. I read it twice. Weird how I miss them now. So cool to hear from Captain Spirit, too. Glad he's doing fine. My Joey sketch doesn't look bad. So glad he's around. April 20th, 2017. I wish I could hear Cass play again. All those songs are gone, but not our time together. April 25th. I fucked up Daniel. I let Finn become his brother. Let's look at that nasty leftovers.
This must be my punishment.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, hospital food usually is. No, I'm just kidding. Actually, hospital food here in Jersey is actually pretty decent. Or at least it was. Back in 2010 was the last time I was hospitalized, so... put it down on the paper.
It's so hard to focus. Gotta practice way more. Not giving up.
Yeah, don't be like me. I gave up.
I guess that's an okay start. But I can keep going.
Like I said, here in Jersey, the hospital food actually isn't that bad. Or, like I said... back in 2010 was the last time I was hospitalized. It wasn't bad. That was over 10 years ago. Draw prison bars. Now we're going to draw a staircase, a way to escape.
It's a way to escape.
Yeah, that'll work.
Wish I could find a highway to freedom.
Wow. I wasn't gonna bring up the matter, Gwen, but...
Yay. Stupid reality shows.
If there is a silver lining, at least he went that way, so he wasn't, you know, like in pain or anything when he passed, so we could all be so lucky. Yeah, I didn't want to press the matter at all. I figured you'd...
This day feels like every other day.
You tell us in your own time.
Just like prison.
So, but like I said, if you need someone to talk to, I'm here. All you gotta do is DM me. If you were, yeah. I don't remember if you were here last
this
time.
This room drives me nuts.
But when you came in, we were probably about 4 or 5 minutes into the story, so if that.
A change.
Yo, afternoon checkup.
Sure.
Good day, sunshine.
Hey, Joey.
Were you here for the last episode?
Hey, man.
Episode 3, was it? Yeah, 3.
That looks like it might have been food. Hard to tell.
Ha ha. Never heard that before.
Oh, somebody is in a bad mood.
Sorry, Joey. Not feeling it today.
I don't blame you. But maybe I got something to cheer you up.
Pecans and chocolate?
Uh-oh. There's that smile.
Thanks, Joey.
I was gonna say,
how you feeling today?
Is it a pot brownie?
Any headaches? Socket pain?
No. It's all good.
Well, this is your final test before... you know. Before they... check you out.
Check me out to juvie. Yeah.
Okay, let's see. You know the drill. Don't blink and just stare at the light.
Yeah, they tell you that, but you know how hard that is?
Yes. Nice retina response. Okay, now, try to follow the light as well as you can.
Oh, really? You're gonna make me fucking...
Come on, Sean. You've been there before. Good, good. Keep going. Straining too hard? Headache?
Nah. I just... can't really focus today. Sorry.
Remember, to see objects on your left side, you gotta turn your head more now. Yes. Looking good, Sean. Now try to align your pen with mine.
I'll try.
No rush. This is tough. Your depth perception will always be affected. So you gotta try harder.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, I know. It's hard.
Oh, what am I supposed to do?
Yeah, that's enough.
Oh, all right, Gwen.
Too much.
I was actually just getting ready. I was trying to go through that whole
but
spiel.
But remember, your depth perception will always be affected. Here. Read this.
All right, well. Soon, these will be up on YouTube, so you'll be able to come back and check them out. I'm a pirate.
I'm a pirate without a patch. Arr. All
right, girl.
I'd be more worried if you weren't such
take
a smart
it easy.
Ass. You can try, but you can't rig the exam, Sean. It's time we release you. Sorry. Your vision has improved a lot.
No, don't let me go.
You don't have severe side effects anymore.
Yeah. That's just great.
I don't want to go to prison.
But first, let's clean this dresser.
Hey, sure hope you're watching the door like your phone.
Come on. He ain't going nowhere.
Great.
All I do is watch him.
Yes, true. Your job.
Wow, somebody sounds like a little bitch.
Do you mind if we talk alone?
Mind if I finish with my patient?
He looks good for now, right? Just come back when I'm finished with him.
Damn, bitch, let him change my dressing first.
Sure.
Whoever the fuck you are, this must be the secret agent lady. Secret
I'll swing by later,
agent
Sean.
Lady? Because we can't say man, because that's apparently sexist.
Stay
even
cool.
Even though it was a song written back in, like, the fucking 70s. Now, you know, gotta be politically correct and all, so.
So, how are you feeling today, Mr. Diaz?
Amazing.
Did you find Daniel?
I want to go over this again.
What?
I've been telling the same fucking story for 3 weeks. How much longer?
Until it makes sense. Until you get it right. So, silence isn't gonna help you now. Listen close, Sean. Tomorrow you're going to Jolena Shore and you'll be arraigned in court.
Woohoo!
For the murder of a Seattle police officer. You might spend the rest of your life in prison. Or you can talk to me.
Not for nothing. I did not explode anything. How could I flip a fucking police car? Like, you would need at least 4 equally strong people to lift a fucking car. Like, average-sized person. You know, you would need, like, at least 4 or 5 average-sized people to flip a fucking car.
I'm innocent until proven guilty, right?
And I believe that. That's why...
You're full of
shit.
I
want you to tell me the whole truth.
It's just... I can't.
Was Daniel involved? Is that why you can't talk?
No, no way.
And you're absolutely sure your dad didn't go after the officer?
Yeah. He came outside. Then he was killed. That's what he did. Just guilty of being...
Mexican.
I hear you, but... You're sure you didn't get upset and go after the officer?
Mm.
It happens.
Jesus, no! Look at me.
Okay, let's just jump ahead. Tell me what happened in that farm in Humboldt. The place looks like a tornado wiped it out.
I've told you so many times. I have no clue why the place was trashed. I passed out.
Plus 3 seriously wounded, along with you. And a missing child. Nobody's statement matches with each other. Sean, throw me a bone here. Can't you see I want to help?
So you haven't found my brother?
You wouldn't believe
me if
I told you.
You can help by telling me the truth.
Okay, fuck.
The robbery. Whose idea was it? His or yours? Huh?
Finn's.
Finn. It was his idea to rip off Meryl.
Did he force you to help? Or did you go along with it?
No, we actually went in to fucking stop him.
He lied. I didn't want to help. But he got Daniel involved. I swear. Swear, I didn't think anything like this was gonna happen.
Nobody does, Sean. Until it's too late.
Yeah. Now I know.
And what about Cassidy? She planned all this with Finn?
She was against this stupid plan. She had nothing to do with it.
Your friends are learning the hard way.
I didn't want any of this shit. Now I gotta live with it.
You're not alone, Sean. There are people that want to help. By the way, we contacted your grandparents in Beaver Creek. They can visit you after you're transferred. Might be a while, but you do have a support group. We couldn't track down your mother, though. Sorry.
Good. What about Daniel? You said you had leads.
I said might. Hold on. I gotta take this call.
Sorry, Finn.
Oh, God damn it.
She didn't want anything to do with this.
Oh, her name is Lucy. Lucy Rose Jones.
Wonder what Meryl told the cops about the robbery.
Wait, he's still alive?
Sorry, Hannah. She lost her family for this. Hope the cops didn't mess with Penny. Prison would fuck him up.
Baptist Dean Mickle. Interesting.
Yes. Hi. Do you have any call? Everything okay?
Well, she's good enough and enough. You know the rules, honey. No, honey. I told you I was gonna be away for a while. I'm sorry, okay? You gotta be good. Okay.
Uh-oh, what, does she have a kid? Yeah, I can't even understand what she's saying. No. She's speaking Spanish.
Sorry about that.
I think I understood like three words out of that whole thing.
So what's going on with Danny? You really have leads?
Yes, we do. That's our job. The Bureau put his profile out over 4 states. So we are on the case.
You lied to me. You have no leads. You have no fucking idea where my brother is.
I don't lie, Sean. But you did. And your brother is paying the price.
Fuck. You. I'm done.
Anyway, thanks for talking to me.
Hey, what's going on, X?
I'll be back tomorrow to take you to Jolina Shore.
Hooray! Looks like he's wearing his shirt backwards.
Look out. I have to guard the guard now. Love it.
Sit down. Oh, that's
down
not good,
so
X.
We can get this show going.
Can't fall asleep during your own stream.
So,
I've had that happen a couple of times.
How did your interview with Scully go?
You mean interrogation? Who knows? Maybe Detective Flores wants to help. Maybe not. I just can't trust her.
After what you and your brother went through, I don't blame you. Oh, this shit is all wrong, man. You've been out of the garden for 3 weeks now. We talk every day. I can see that you're a good person.
Thanks, Joey. Want to tell that to the judges?
I'm just saying, you don't deserve this. Now let's check this out.
Oh, are we gonna get to see it? Show me. I wanna see it.
The healing is coming along nice. Just gotta keep it clean for the next week or so.
Let me see it.
Simple.
That's great.
Seen the shrink this morning?
I wanna see it.
Say?
Nothing I wanna hear. This will take time and rehab, Sean. You have to process first. Ugh. I could tell myself that shit.
That's not good enough.
Clearly,
show it to
I'm
me.
No
I wanna
therapist,
see the gooiness.
I've nursed patients with your injury. They all turned their anger into energy. You will too.
Yeah, okay, Teddy.
Plus,
after like what looks like at least a 3-story drop.
Cool now. Things change, Sean.
You break the glass and get out of there. Yeah, okay. You'd be breaking more than just the glass. So it looks like he's at least on the 2nd or 3rd level of that hospital.
I hear you. I'm trying to be positive.
We want to be positive.
But it's so hard.
Oh, there you go, X. At least you got some followers out of it.
I know. I do. But I promise there's a treat coming your way.
Actually, he may
now
even be on
for
the top
your
level.
Wound, this is the last time you hear this from me. You have to clean it with sterile gauze and saline solution.
Sterile gauze, saline solution. Show it to me! I want to see the eye! I want to see if it's anything like Carl's from The Walking Dead.
Coat the area using the swab and cream.
Swab and cream. Well, except for the fact that Carl actually got his eye shot out. His had a piece
then
of
wrap
glass
it up
in
with
it.
Clean dressing.
Show me.
You're the shit.
God damn
remember,
nice.
You gotta do this.
4 times a day.
It is not fair. I want to see it.
I won't forget.
I'm sorry about everything, Sean.
I already forgot.
Wish I could have done more.
Dude, you saved my ass here. You're the only one I trust. It really helped.
Cool. I'm glad when I can make a check.
He do seem like a good guy.
Shit. Emergency. I'm out. And no smoke break. Let's say our goodbye tomorrow. Oh, Sean, check out that towel. Got your name all over it. Catch you later.
You mean Carl there, Rogue? That's who I was talking about, Rick's son.
Joey.
It's actually boss. It's sticking more to the comic books now. They're actually going back more towards the comic books. So.
What? Wow.
Oh, no shit.
Haven't seen you in a long time.
He's cool. I like him. I knew I liked him. He got us our sketchbook. Yay, yay. That we also write in too, so it could. It's technically a journal with doodles.
I know I fucked Daniel over. Again. And now he's gone.
True,
but.
Where
would he hide out?
What most people don't understand is.
10-year-old by himself? Out there? He might go back to Seattle. But too far. Nowhere to go. If he tried to hook up with Claire and Steven, they would have definitely told me. Or the cops. Wait. What's that? Super Wolf.
As I was saying, yeah, you gotta remember though, there's.
It means that Daniel. Daniel's with Jacob somewhere?
There's actually three different safe. Universes now.
I could see him again.
Well, two, technically. You got the comic books, and then you got the TV, and then the Walking Dead and Fear the Walking Dead, and soon to be the new one. I forget what the title of it is. The one with the kids. That's all the TV universe. That's totally different from the comics, and that's what a lot of people are pissed off about. But it's still not bad. Had a few beers. Daniel's asleep. Same night. Every night. He wants to train more, but we don't have time. We gotta hide. It's not easy. Borrowed a blanket and a few other things from your tent. We'll give them back to you when you come looking for your Super Wolf comic. It's waiting for you, Jake. Sweet. Cassie the Wild and versus Hannah the Wild. That's nice. Meh, it's not terrible. It's not great, but it's not bad. A fucking woo! I'm a swear wolf. Fuck, fuck, fuck. Daniel messed up again. Gotta fix that shit. So fucking tired of running away. Okay, so. Depression night, everyone shared their worst memories. Everyone feeling like shit. What a wonderful world. Got a new haircut tonight. Feel like a different person, but I like it. Is there anything Finn can't do? Agent 420, give me hot dogs.
All I gotta do is find that page with Jacob's home. Haven Point, Nevada.
Met the new workers from Europe. Anders and Ingrid, or Ingrid. Ingrid. It's usually with an I, as from what I understand. Cute couple makes me want to travel overseas someday. Had a long talk with Jacob. He's like a little kid. He lives in some religious commune from Haven Point, Nevada. Looks fine here. Free.
Yeah. I gotta get to him.
Nevada!
I gotta find a way to escape.
Good luck with that.
Tonight.
It went all black screen on us.
Sacred Hope. Okay, so we were on the second level, okay. I thought.
Time to clear off now.
Is it second or third?
This whole hospital is so quiet.
Yeah, but I'm
so
pretty
don't
sure.
Make any noise. And find a way to get the hell out of here. Maybe I could,
what?
Rig a decoy Sean in the bed.
I was gonna say, break the window and then climb down on a rope sheet ladder?
I don't think so.
Yeah, shove them in your non-existing pockets.
Nada.
Niente.
Joey's the only one who helped me get through this shit.
Maybe he will help us. Take everything we can.
Just in case.
Maybe is there anything in the drawer? No.
Wish I could just walk out. They've been working on these rooms forever. So fucking loud. My backpack has got to be somewhere around here. Let's see. I just gotta get past that locked door and an angry guard.
Electrical switchboard, fire extinguisher. Oh, show me the eye. Show me the eye. Take it off. Let me take. Oh, come on. What a tease. That's a fucking cock tease and a half.
This one isn't screwed in. Let's do it.
It's probably gonna make noise.
Hey, what the hell are you doing in there?
Taking a shit. There was probably a quieter way to get that done.
Nice
but.
Job, Sean. Now the guard is awake and pissed off.
Whoopsie.
Maybe I can trick him. Say I need an aspirin or something.
Hang on that for a second.
Joey could probably distract the guard dog.
Alright, let's call Joey. Really don't want to get him involved, but...
Can I have some privacy, please?
I was gonna say, hospital windows are supposed to be locked.
Need a superhero to open that shit. Hope my last view of this world isn't this window. One stupid car.
I see.
And I'm out of here.
I was gonna say, I see three or four, but... Okay.
I could slip into one of those rooms under construction.
Oh, shit. Hang on.
It's dead tonight. Works for me.
You got business in there?
Patient called. Just gotta see what our boy needs.
Good. I need a smoke break.
Hey, that's your job. Go for it.
Right.
Hey, there's my second favorite patient. Gotcha.
You never stop working, Joey.
I'm doing a double night shift. Diane is out with a flu, so lucky me. Yeah, I'm fried. But that sweet, sweet overtime.
Right.
Sean, you look stressed. You feeling okay?
Yeah. I know where my brother is.
What? How?
I found a note in the sketchbook you brought me. He's in Nevada. With, a friend of ours.
Fuck, Sean. That's awesome. Now that's good news.
Mm-hmm. And I need you
Nevada
to help me.
Nevada sucks, but at least the kid is safe.
Listen, Joey. I need to get out of here.
What? Come on, Sean. You know I can't let you do that. You know I'm on your side, man. I don't blame you for being scared. You're leaving tomorrow. But don't fuck around with this.
Help me, man.
You hear me?
I'm innocent.
I'm innocent. You know I am.
I didn't even do anything.
You even told me.
I said you're a good kid. But it doesn't matter what I think about you. I'm not the police. You really want me to help you break out of here. So what happens to me? I lose my job, go to jail. I have a girlfriend, a rent to pay, a future.
True.
Sorry. I'm sorry, Joey. I was being selfish. I want to help my brother. It's all I can think about. He's 10 years old and out there all alone. He needs his big brother.
Sean, I wish I could help you. I swear, but I can't do this.
Joey, please.
Look, it's not fair to ask me to give up my job and my life.
He's got a point.
To maybe possibly help you escape?
I know. I'm just desperate.
Let's forget about this, okay? I'll do anything else I can to help. Now, I really gotta get back to my shift. I'm tired already.
I'm not gonna ask him to help me. I'm not gonna attack Joey either. That's fucked up. That's so wrong. I don't wanna hurt him. Figure out my own way. If the guard's gone, he went to go smoke, so he should be gone for a minute.
You have a good night, Doc.
Fuck.
I could trick him into coming in here and then knock him out.
Let's make a makeshift body in the bed, break the window lock, and try and get into the construction room.
That looks so fake.
Mm-hmm.
But it might work for a second.
Why are there no circles for where the screws were? Did the guard hear that? I don't think he did! Sweet. I'm gonna die.
This is Gracie, dude.
Here goes nothing.
Don't freak out. Just get out.
We're gonna fucking die. We're going to fucking die. Keep going. Don't be a pussy. You shouldn't be looking out that way anyway. You should be looking towards the wall. Oh, fuck. They're gonna make me do it. No, wait, should I?
Don't think.
Can I close the window?
Just keep going.
No, I don't want to come back inside. I was going to close the window to keep suspicions down. Excuse me. I'm going to fucking, he's going to slip, isn't he?
Holy shit.
There it is.
Take a breath, dude.
Stop being a bitch. Continue on. He's scared. Yeah, we did it. Because nobody else hears that shuffling on the scaffolding.
Way too close.
Magically, one of the windows is going to be open. Called it.
Time to get my shit from the staff room.
Is that where the fucking all your shit is? In the staff room? I don't know why the police wouldn't have it in lockup, but alright.
Okay, the guard is sleeping. This is your big chance, dude.
The guard also looks like he's wearing a pair of blue jeans. Fucking did it! Motherfuckers! So now Joey doesn't get in trouble, and we're good to go. There you go. You're already gonna be a fugitive, might as well steal shit too. Damn, so we could have done that without even getting Joey involved. Maybe I should go back and not call Joey so that way he's not involved, because he's gonna get in trouble.
That's Finn. No way. What is he doing here?
Fuck him. Nah, fuck him. Oh, too late. Sorry, Rogue. Do it. Yeah, fine. Let's add Grand Theft Auto to the list too. He's like, I'm innocent, but he didn't kill the cop, but he did all this shit.
escaping custody, evading, blowing up a weed farm. Not wake him, go back and not involve Joey. You want me to go back? Grand Theft Auto to the list, and he almost hit the scaffolding. If you guys want me to go back, I'll go back, but I usually kind of like to stick with the decisions that I make in this kind of shit. Kind of like a one-time playthrough thing. I mean, I'll play it again. I'll stream this again. This game's fucking great enough to play a couple of times. So we successfully escaped without waking the guard! Well, we woke him once when we broke the bar. There's probably a quiet way to do it, but I ain't about that shit. Oh, he's gonna crash. Pull over, dude. Take a few winks. You're gonna fucking drift off the road and fucking crash. I wonder what happened to my awesome fucking mohawk. I'm a little mad about that. Oh, really? What, if you used a blanket to break the grab bar off the wall? I mean, it might muffle the sound, but wouldn't do much. Whatever. I didn't get caught, and that is the most important thing. Episode 4. We are what, 45 minutes into the gameplay, and we are now finally getting the intro sequence. With the Life is Strange 2 logo. Welcome to Nevada, Pacific time zone. I'm on the East Coast, so we go by Eastern. Look at that, kid doing it the old-fashioned way with a map. Wait, Minecraft has a story mode? Really?